In the 2023-2024 financial year budget, agro-industrialization, a sector which accounts for 50% of the national exports and employs over 64%, is allocated 1.499 trillion shillings out of a resource envelope of 50 trillion shillings, which represents 3.2% of the national total budget. Now, civil society organizations, including Civil Society Budget Advocacy Groups, CSBAG, and Food Rights Alliance, have come out to criticize the budgetary allocations for the agriculture sector.
It has been implemented by two nutrition action plans. We are not seeing this in the ministerial policy statement. So this is another recommendation we are making alongside this issue of food security, and also devising to see that we create an alternative input source for farmers if we are all going to wait for food.
Appearing before the Parliamentary Committee of Agriculture to give their position on the agro-industrialization program in response to the ministerial policy statement for the financial year 2023-2024, CSOs expressed concerns over absence of a clear strategy and policy to address food security in the country.
Cabinet instructed the Ministry of Agriculture to spearhead the process of reviewing the food and nutrition policy. Our food and nutrition policy is dated 2003. This year, our food and nutrition policy is celebrating two decades. By standard, a policy is supposed to be reviewed after 10 years.
They expressed concerns of high costs of quality seeds and faulted the government for phasing out a program of providing free seeds to farmers during planting seasons.
So there is no distribution of any form of resources, and yet we have not created an alternative. Now what is happening out there? You may be aware that now a kilogram of maize seed is ranging between 10,000 and 15,000.
According to recent surveys, an estimated 10.9 million people are experiencing acute food insecurity in Uganda, of which 1.6 million, that is 5% of the population, are in a crisis. CSOs now want the government to allocate 400 billion shillings annually for food security interventions in the next 2 years. They believe this will help to establish national food reserves and give a final blow to further outbreaks of hunger and famine.
To have those regional storage facilities, and then we see resources allocated and even facilitated, but also working at the systems of these storage facilities.
The proposal was welcomed by the committee chaired by Janet Grace Okorimo, who appreciated a need to deal with food security comprehensively.
Like you have said, now it is raining, but farmers there, out there, are not doing the planting. I don't know what happened to us.
Because even free distribution of inputs actually didn't work. We got some little food in the families, but we didn't realize volumes in exports.
I don't know where we got this cash from. We have good policies, good laws, but the implementation stage. That is why now there is a blame game between the politicians and the technocrats.
CSOs also highlighted issues of inadequate financing for disease control, poor storage infrastructure and post-harvest management, plus low compliance to quality and standards. Others include absence of national irrigation master plan and inadequate financing of agricultural extension services.
We have to start making selective, strategic, conscious decisions in the sector.
Story compiled by Fred Kajubi for the News at Parliament.